Thank you everyone for attending this meeting. My name is Tariqul Islam. I'm working for City of Fort Worth as a graduate engineer in Transportation and Public Works Department. This meeting is for 2021 Resurfacing Street Maintenance Project. As I said, I will be the project manager. The city inspector for this project would be John Crowley. Construction contractor will be PHT Construction. The estimated construction cost is approximately $1.5 million. And project is scheduled to start in April 5. And hopefully it will be completed in November 2021. Project limits, there are multiple locations in these projects. They are all over the city. Starts with Clayton Road. You see the limits of the Clayton Road from Camboe to Brands Road. Clotilde Drive from East Berry to East Land Street. Main Street from Ellis to Martha. We have Mockingbird Lane from Simondale to West Dead End. We have Redbird Lane and Slate Street next to each other. We have Wellesley Avenue, Prevost to Harvey Street. We have Wessex Avenue, Wedgeworth Road to Welch Avenue. These are the streets, and the scope of work would be the slit replacement of curb and gutter, drive approaches, and of course, roadway resurfacing. Here are a couple of examples for the scope of work. On the left side of the screen, you can see the damaged driveway and curb and gutter, those kind of damaged driveway and curb and gutter would be replaced. And after the completion of the contract, on the right side of the screen, you will see the street supposed to look like. This is an example only. On the left side of the screen, existing street condition of the asphalt street. And after the paving is complete, hopefully it will look like on the right side of the screen. During construction, there are some temporary impact. Every construction have some impacts. It can be some sounds, some dust, some limited parking availability, and of course there will be some construction equipment will be there, and we will try to minimize those impacts. Enough signage will be placed around the sites, and also good communication will be there towards the citizen during the whole contract. Is there any temporary closure? It will be notified ahead of time. Driveways or parking will be blocked by any equipment during constructions. If any driveway needs to be closed temporarily for construction, it will be definitely communicated ahead of time with the residents. And for any streets before the construction begin, definitely we will pass the door hangers for each of the residents to let them know what the construction is coming. Our regular working hours would be Monday to Friday from 7 a.m. to 6 p.m. Here is my contact information, my phone number, and my email address. You can contact me anytime for any question for the projects through phone or through email. Any questions? Now you can unmute yourself and ask a question, or you can use the chat box.
Which project do you plan to start first?
That is not finalized yet at this moment. But as I said, we will get 10 days notice. They prior to start construction, the first street we're going to start. You will notify each of the residents through door hanger.
My name is Joe Graham, and my reasoning for joining this meeting is a concern on Clayton Road. We have stop signs and we have speed bumps. I request, talking with several neighbors, I don't know if they're signed in. I just see three people signed in up here. Our request is leave the speed bumps or put in some kind of something that would slow down the traffic because they do not pay attention. Most of the people do not pay attention to the stop signs. There are slow down signs and sometimes there's no sign at all as far as the people are concerned. They use Clayton Road to connect from Camp Bowie over to 183 and it's a thoroughfare. And we have a very walking neighborhood, children play. Personally, we have our great grandchildren here awful lot, other people. So our request is leave the speed bump.
Okay, thank you, sir, for your questions. But as far as I know, city's policy it do not to have any speed bump in the residential streets. But I will check if this policy is still there, and I will pass your request to concerned section if they need any speed bump, as you said, for the kids and the older elderly people. They will evaluate the streets and definitely get back with you. Can you please send me an email with your information so that we can contact you later? You have my email address here.
I certainly do, and I have it on the flyer that you sent out from the city of Fort Worth.
That is correct.
Well, suggestions, if you're in for suggestions, do we send this with the email? Because I could really talk on the subject a long time, and I know there's other people who want to ask the questions.
Yes, that will be great. I understand your question, but as I said, as far as I know the city's policy, we are removing all the speed bumps from the neighborhood streets, but it is because of it causing hazards to the people, as far as I know. We're removing existing speed bumps, but I understand your questions. As I said, please send me an email. I will send your request to concerned sections. They will evaluate and get back with you.
I appreciate your concern. Thank you very much.
You're welcome, sir.
I have a kind of a answer to Joe. I live on Athenia and we had two speed bumps on our road. And what was happening was people were speeding up faster, because the faster you go over speed bumps, the less you feel them. And so now that the speed bumps are removed, the traffic's actually slowed down. And that's just from observation, and just wanted to tell you that's our case and what we experienced, because I believed in what you said too, that it is a neighborhood and kids play, but I have noticed that cars don't go faster now, they go slower because they tried to go fast so they couldn't feel it. And that was counterproductive, it seemed like, but I feel you.
Yeah, the speed humps actually was voted by the city council members not to be replaced, because to keep them, we have to keep them maintained, and there is no funds to keep them maintained, because you have to keep those reflected marking on it so people can see it at night. Also, like Jimmy said, we found that people speed in between the two humps to make the difference when they slow down for the timing. Like I slow down here, they go fast, so if they can catch up with the time wherever they're going. And the only thing we found out from the study, it slows down the emergency vehicles like fire and police and ambulance.
I have a question. I live on Wessex Avenue and it was resurfaced with asphalt just a few years ago. What is it being done this time to ensure that the road will last longer this time? I assume it's going to be resurfaced with asphalt again. Is that correct?
Yes, sir. It will be pulverized. We're going to pulverize 10 inches of asphalt and put cement and compacted the grade and put a new asphalt top, like 2 inches of asphalt top.
Now the construction company was out here lowering the gas lines going under the road surface, and they just finished that project, and I assume that they were lowered so that you could work deeper into the surface without disturbing the gas lines going under the street. Is that correct?
That is correct, sir. That's why they go ahead and our construction begins. They're supposed to lower their line so that we can pulverize the 10 inch of streets and put new asphalt on top.
Okay. The last time they did the surface, they didn't go down as deep.
There's a two different procedure. Maybe the last time they only milled the surface and put a new asphalt, but in this procedure, we're going to go deep and pulverize and make good compaction, make, you know, cement stabilize the base and put a new asphalt on the top. This is a different procedure. Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, also not necessarily they lower their line. What they do, they take advantage of us going to pave the road. We let all the utility companies know that we're going to repair the street, so they don't have to come and cut it after our project. So they go ahead and if they have to replace old lines, they replace them. So not necessarily they just want to lower them. Sometimes they do lower them if they're shallow, and sometimes they just replace it with existing, the old one.
Okay. Thank you very much.
I do have a question. I live on Athenia again, and I saw that you, on the examples that you showed, that we, of course, I do not have a curb at all, and I'm guessing you will put a curb in. And then also I noticed on one of the examples you showed that some of them did not have sidewalks, and then they have sidewalks after your construction. So those, will that continue all the way around the neighborhood, or will it just be for the sidewalks be put on, like for me that just doesn't have a curb at all?
If you don't have any carbon gutter will be installed in this project. That's what, as far as I know. Is there any gap in the carbon gutter, we're gonna, you know, fill the gap with new carbon gutter. But for sidewalk, is if you don't have any sidewalk in your street, there will not be any sidewalk installed under this project.
Yes, we have sidewalks on some, and sidewalks on, and no sidewalks on some. So that's kind of what I was asking. If the whole neighborhood has sidewalks.
Yes, sir. Those are partial sidewalks. Which road are you on, sir?
The address is 400 Athenia.
Athenia, okay.
Yes, my sir. Drive faces Slate.
Yes, sir. You are where the sidewalk you're talking about, this is was bought by the developer who built the house at the corner. Correct? That was bought by the developer. This project is funded through maintenance fund, and we only replace what's missing, like the curb and gutter driveways we can do there, but to have sidewalk is not, it is that comes from the fund, which is that has to be through a capital bond program.
Okay.
We have to reconstruct the street.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I have a question.
Please go ahead.
Yeah, I live on Clotel Drive, and He was saying that you're going to be doing some work on that street. So what's necessary to be done on that street?
Is this Clotel Drive?
Yes.
So we are doing Clotel Drive between Eastland and Berry Street. Are you living on this block?
3800.
Yes, ma'am. That your road is not bad. The curb and gutter on your road and the driveways, they're not really bad. However, if any damaged curb and gutter driveways, we will replace it, and we're gonna repave the street. But it will be no sidewalk in there.
Okay, I'm sorry. I didn't understand what you said.
I said on your road, you don't have sidewalks in there, do you?
No, we don't have sidewalks.
You do?
No, we don't. No.
Yes, ma'am, you don't. Yeah. So what we're gonna do? We're not installing any new sidewalk. The curb and gutter and the driveways, they're not that bad.
Well,
still in good condition, majority of it.
Ask him a question.
However, if there is some broken or damaged, we replace it, and we're gonna repave the whole entire road with the new asphalt and base.
Okay, as far as I can tell, it doesn't need anything done to it, so that's why I was surprised that you have a street on there.
Yeah, if you look at the pavement itself, you can see lots of cracks and lots of deep cracks in there. What we do with this program, we're trying to capture the streets like that before they go really way down and we have to reconstruct it. So that's what we maintain, and this is a maintenance program.
Okay, now when is this going to start?
We have several streets on this project, and we have not scheduled any. We'll get with the contractor where he's going to start it. Like, we have about 6 streets, and they're all over the city. And at the time we come to any street, we will put a door hang information at your door to let you know that we're coming within a few days.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you.
You're welcome.
Are you still there?
Yes.
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, may I ask a question?
Please go ahead.
Thank you. I'm on Colonial, I'm on Mockingbird Lane. It's that really large street in Fort Worth. Several years ago, y'all were going to, the water department was going to, the water and sewer, they were going to replace the water main down the street and the sewer line to a bigger capacity. And that's, you know, that should have already happened by now, according to what the meeting, you know, that I went to many years ago. Now I understand you're going to come down Mockingbird Lane and redo the street. Are they going to do any water line work at the same time, or what's going to happen there?
All those streets were cleared by war and all utilities, as there is no work needs to be done on that street.
Okay, because the work never got done that they said that they were going to do. So
I don't know, sir, because that's a different department, and we don't know what's on their agenda. But for us, we send them a notification to let them know that we are working on those streets.
Okay.
And they told us we're clear to go, so there's no work for them to do.
Okay. And so, in other words, you don't have a timeline yet of when you're going to be on, say, Mockingbird Lane, because the contract has not been let yet.
Yes, sir. Well, no, the contract is let already. We have this is it's on a contract, but we have not had the pre. We do a construction meeting with the contractor. And we'll ask him for a schedule to give us the schedule what they're going to work.
Okay.
So we have not got the schedule from the contractor yet. But all of those projects, all of those streets should get done and finished and complete before the end of the year.
Are they going to put a sidewalk on our street?
No, sir.
Let me ask you this question. I live across from the 15th Fairway. But as you're going west down the street, the curb stops. Are y'all gonna, when y'all repave the street, are y'all gonna finish curbing the rest of the street on the Colonial side?
If there is a small portion missing, we will replace it. But if the whole entire length will not, especially on right, onto, I believe on the north side where the golf course is.
Yeah.
That's probably we're not gonna add any more sidewalk in there.
You're not gonna, well, I'm not talking about the sidewalk now. I'm talking about the curb.
The also curb will not put in at the side of the golf course. And the reason for that, because there is a semi-bar ditch, and if we put curb and gutter, will cause a flooding because the water has to go somewhere.
Okay. Okay. All right.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry. Can you hear me?
Sure.
I apologize very much. I came to this meeting a little late.
No problem.
jumped off the couch and realized it was already going on. So you may have already answered some of these questions. I live on Clayton Road East in Ridgely Hills. And I know that the stretch is supposed to go from Camp Bowie down Clayton Road East and end at Brant's. You mentioned that even though the contracts were out, that you didn't necessarily have a hard and fast timeline as to when this would begin, maybe in our particular area, but it would end by the end of the year. Am I correct on that?
Yes, ma'am. Weather permits, because we don't know how Texas weather is. Because like from now till May or June, we're gonna have rain, hopefully not, but that's what we scheduled. We should finish before the end of the year. Yes, ma'am.
What would be the time frame that we might be given as residents on that section of the street to know when it will begin? Would we get like maybe a 2-week notice or?
Yeah, yes. Well, you'll get the thing. Tariq, we're still doing 7-day notice, right?
Yes, ma'am. You will get notified ahead of time, like 2 weeks notice and a 2 days notice. We'll get 2 notices. So once we start, you'll definitely get 2 notices prior to start.
Okay.
And those notices, man, they're going to be at the front door. So I know lots of people go through their garage and they never use the front door and they miss it. Just, you know, keep looking, see the door hang
and
the front door. And also you have the project manager's information. You're welcome to call anytime and check, and we'll be happy to let you know.
So within like our area from the beginning to the end, it's not a huge stretch of a street, but depending upon when permits come in, when we get notices, it still could possibly extend to the end of the year. And in addition to that question, I'd like to ask, will speed pumps be put on the street?
No, ma'am. We have Mr. Graham, I think he asked the same question earlier. The speed humps no longer are permitted by council members. The council members, they all vote against them, because to keep them, we have to have fund to maintain them, because we have to put those reflected marking on it. Also,
well, I apologize. I wasn't, like I said, I was late to the meeting. So
yeah, no, Brian, I'm doing much to repeat myself. I just want to let you know we said that. No, don't worry about that. Okay. Sorry about that. I don't mean it that way. But that will happen. And also from our study, we found out that the drivers, especially teenagers in these days, more drivers than adults, they slow down because you have one of those slow cars. But to make the difference in timing, because it slowed down, they go on speed right after the speed hump, just to make up the time. And so we did not find that any helpful to slow down the traffic. And the only problem we found that it'll slow the emergency vehicles down, like police, ambulance, fire.
Okay.
And we don't want them to be slowed down to get to where they're going.
Makes sense.
Yes, ma'am.
Can I ask another question?
Sure, sir.
Hey, this is going back to Mockingbird Lane. As you're redoing the streets, some of these drive approaches on this street are in bad shape. Some of them are brand new because of new construction. Are y'all going to, on the bad drive approaches, are y'all going to fix those where they're not collecting water and mosquitoes and stuff during the summertime?
Yes, sir. All of those driveways that hold in water and damaged, they will be replaced.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
I have a question. I live on West 6th Avenue. And probably 10 years ago, our street was redone. And they did the, they didn't put down concrete. They, what they called it was recycled asphalt. And I am just wondering if they're going to redo it the way they did before, or are they going to come in with a better surface? Because this thing, it's worse now than when they repaired it several years ago.
Yes, sir. We do not use reused asphalt or recycled asphalt. That's the NEPA was allowed in the city of Fort Worth. What they did back then, we just removed the top of 2 inches and we put a new 2 inches because the base was still good. Now, after 10 years, the base started to deteriorate. And what we're doing, we're going to go and pulverize the full depth of the field, like from the surface going down 11 inches. We're going to mix that with cement. We're going to stabilize it and compact it. And we'll put a new asphalt on top of it. So we're doing okay, that. So we're going 11 feet deep, 11 inches solid deep.
Well, you know, on the 5800 block of Wessex, because I live at 5700, I'm right in the middle of the block. And the 5800 block, when theirs was resurfaced, they did that street with concrete. And you come across Welch, and we've got this recycled asphalt, and it probably, maybe about 4 years, it started deteriorating. And it's really bad right now. I mean, it is. It's just a terrible street to drive down. It's even terrible to walk down. But anyway, well, I was just curious to what type of surface they're going to come back with. And do you have a time frame on that?
Yeah, yes, sir. Let me ask the first, answer the first part of comparing this street to the others with concrete. The one with concrete, those streets are, goes through bond. And those streets are, has to, every street has to compete with citywide to be the list, which is the select the worst of the worst in the city. And what we're doing for this street now, this is program right now, this is through a maintenance. That's why we don't do it with concrete or with asphalt, because it's different bond or different fund.
Actually. Okay. So. Yeah. It will go back the way it was, but that's okay.
It's better because we're not just paving, but replacing the surface. We're going deep, 11 inches to 12 inches to treat the base.
Okay.
Yeah, and it will last much longer. Yeah, for the timing, at this time, we don't know where the contractor is going to start, and hopefully we'll have probably in a week or two more information about the diamond, and we'll be happy to send out or call everybody. We have a brother Zemir who attended. We have information. We'll send it to you to tell you, you know, approximate time when they come in. But keep looking at the front door, where the door hang, and that's when we can let you know that's when we come in, definitely.
Okay. Well, thank you very much for your time.
Robson.
To follow up on what Richard was saying, I'm sorry, go ahead.
I have an additional question on Clotel. And right in front of my house, it's kind of a low place, and every time it rains or water's running from the other end, it stands right in front of my house. So will you be doing anything for that?
You're talking about within those blocks that you live within the street. We're gonna do right.
Right. I do.
Yeah. They'll be taking care of it, ma'am. Yeah. You won't have any water standing.
Okay. All right. Well, thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Back to like what Richard, the same question that Richard asked about the material that you're going to use on Mockingbird Lane. Are you going to go back with asphalt, or are you going to go back with concrete?
It's all asphalt, yeah. Like I said, this is funded through a maintenance. Maintenance, we don't do concrete. The only thing, if you don't do concrete, it has to go through the bond funding. And that will have to be voted on by the citizens and agree to it. And we have a bond every 4 years, and that has to be voted by the citizens on it. And some of those not really qualified for the bond, the one that goes to the bond, the really most likely really streets that you cannot drive on them anymore, because you have a bunch of them all over the city.
Yeah, well, I just didn't know, because some of these bond elections that we have and they get passed, they don't get spent till years later. So I didn't know where we fell into that situation.
Yes, sir. Now this funded through maintenance budget.
Well, that makes sense. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
So I'm assuming, however, with digging down 11 inches deep, that the stabilization of the foundation of the road should be better than what it has been. Is that correct?
Absolutely, ma'am. Yes, because it's going to be retreated and put, you know, it's now because with diamond, you have lots of moisture, lots of water, lots of heavy traffic on it and trucks do it mess up the base. That's why you see lots of cracks and buttholes and what have you. So this is going to be treated and it will last longer.
Thank you.
Okay, I have another question. Will we be getting new curbs and driveway approaches?
Where is
Wessex?
Wessex, only we're replacing damaged pieces. We're not replacing 100%.
Yeah, because see, the last time they gave us all new curbs all the way up and down both sides of the street, and everyone got a new approach in their driveway. So they may not have to replace the curbs or the approaches. I don't know.
Right. Yes, sir. What we do, it's if when we build the new streets, like something going through the bond, we replace it 100%. This is maintenance fund. And if the curb or the driveway is still in good shape, it's not holding water, we're not going to replace it. Oh. But if it's causing a problem or if it's damaged, we will replace it.
Okay. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Well, y'all have a good evening.
You too. Thank you.
I found out what I needed to know.
Thank you very much. I appreciate you.
You're welcome, sir.
Y'all have a good night.
Call us anytime you have the information. If you have any question or think any questions later on.
I have a question.
Sure.
Going back to Athena and Slate at 400 Athena.
Yes.
Can you show that design and tell me again? Apparently, do you have a photo of that corner there on Athena and Slate? Where Slate starts.
This one, the one with the U shape. This one.
Yeah. Okay. On this end of, on the Athena end of Slate, he was talking about there's no curb on that side and it floods. So is that going to be fixed at the same time?
Yes, ma'am. We're gonna put the curb and we will eliminate any flooding or any issues.
Okay. But I was just concerned because you said if there wasn't a curb there already, you weren't replacing them.
Right. So. No. We're talking about the sidewalk. There's no sidewalk, so we're not adding sidewalk.
Well, yeah.
But we will replace curb and gutters and driveways, yes, ma'am.
Okay. All right.
Thank you very much for your time this evening and for letting me dial in. I appreciate it.
I'm welcome with them, man. Thank you for joining.
I have a question. You had said that I'm on Athena 400 Athena, and you said that if I didn't have a sidewalk, probably wouldn't get one because that falls in a bond package. Did you say Fort Capital or Fort Plan?
Right, the sidewalk has, if we put sidewalk, has to be for the entire street. We don't just put portion of sidewalks. So, and like I said, this is to put sidewalks, that's under a different program, has to go through the bond and has to be, most of those sidewalks go into places like where school are. You know, if you have school or people walking into like a church or a school, or we do study and we see how many people using the road and walking. So it has to compete with all other city streets in the city to qualify for sidewalk. But for curb and gutter, there is no but curb and gutter and fix the driveway approach for drainage purposes. So to eliminate water going into anybody's yards. Yeah, and I noticed, you know, because there's like people building new houses and lots of new development. For anybody who's developed any new, like building a house or a building or apartments in that area, that's required by the city for the developer to install sidewalks. That's what you see, some new sidewalk within the approved lot. Any other questions?
I think you answered all of mine. I greatly appreciate you taking the time to do this.
You're welcome. No problem, sir.
So because we called in or joined in, you've got our email addresses, so you'll be sending us some updates to our email addresses and then look for the door hanger on the doors, right?
Yes, sir. We'll be happy to inform you. And if you have any questions or you didn't hear from us for a while, please give us a call. And you have the number right here on the screen. If you
I got your number, big guy. I'm gonna put it in my phone.
Yeah. You can call us anytime. We'll be happy to answer your questions.
If you want, just take a picture.
Hey,
just take a picture of the screen.
Riyadh, yes. this is Jeff. We don't the system doesn't store email addresses. So if they want email update, they'll have to send an email to Tariq.
Yeah, that's why that's why I put my email address here and the phone number. Please email your question or concern, anything you have about this project. You can call us, you can email us. So this way we can answer your, you know, future questions or concern, because we don't keep the email address of the attendees.
All right, now we're flip flopping. Okay.
No, that's my fault. I'm just answering the questions.
I'll send you an email. I appreciate it.
Yeah.
Just and you're welcome to call with this number at any time and email us, you know. If you don't hear from us, you don't see any activities for a while, shoot us an email or call us. We'll be happy to.
Yeah. As I said, we're starting in April, but we haven't scheduled which street we're going to be first. So it will take time, few months to complete the whole project. Like from April to October, November. So before we go for any street, we will receive the door notification, the door hangers, at least 10 days ahead of the time. So you will get time. And if you don't get notice for longer period to get the information or which time you're gonna go, please contact me, as I said, with my email or phone number. We can give you the approximate time when you're gonna be on your street.
Perfect.
And I'll just say this, sorry I'm a little late. This is Michael Crane. I'm the District 3 director. And if you can't get any of those guys, feel free to reach out to me through the District 3 office, and I'm happy to help however I can.
Well, that'd be great. I enjoyed your emails over the freeze week, the ice week we had. So it was good.
Thank you. We're still pushing some of those. I realize that the city was not putting out communications as they should. And I said, what do I have? And I said, I've got my emails and other things. I'll just try and get information out as fast as possible, people. So I appreciate it.
That helped. That was nice. That was really nice. Well, I'm going to bug off. You guys have a good evening. And I thank you again for all the, for all your help.
No problem, sir.
Have a nice evening. Thank you.
You as well. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
So I believe, is there any other question?
Question
Tariq,
in the chat box.
There was one question in chat that we haven't answered from Danielle Tucker, but I think she's off the call, but I'd still like to get it recorded in case she watches. Is there an MWBE goal on this project?
Yes, we have MWBE goal, but I don't recall the exact percentage, maybe 3 or 4% for this project. But if anybody can call me or contact me, I can provide you MWBE goal. Yes, there's certainly an MWBE goal for these projects.
Great. Thank
all city projects have MWBE participation.
Any more questions? All right, looks like we answered all the questions. So far, we don't have any more. This program use presentation will be uploaded in CT's YouTube channel later for future viewing. And thank you everyone for attending this meeting. Thank you all. Have a nice evening. We are closed ending this presentation right now. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good night.
Thank you.
Good night.